Welcome back to Digital Trends Live, broadcasting across our different social media platforms right now, YouTube, Facebook, Periscope, and Twitch. Drop in your comments, your questions. Let us know what you want to discuss. And this subject is actually really important to me because I have had packages stolen off of my front porch. Who hasn't? There are ways that you can help prevent that because today is actually National Package Protection Day. There's a day for everything. This is it. And I'm Greg Nibbler here, joined now by Kim Wetzel, our smart home editor. Hello, Kim.
Hi, how are you?
Doing well. I mean, this Good. Is perfectly timed. National It makes sense since everybody ordered a bunch of stuff off of, probably ordered a lot of stuff off of Amazon.
Amazon mostly, yeah.
Cyber Monday and Black Friday, and now everything's getting delivered.
Yes, I read that like something in the neighborhood of like 30 million packages just from Amazon alone for Black Friday and Cyber Monday. Yeah, so...
So it's like a field day. If you were a thief, this is your Christmas.
Right? Well, it's everyone's Christmas, but yeah, absolutely. yeah, it is. It's a problem. I don't know. You've had packages.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
And yet having them delivered, and I shouldn't be saying this out loud, probably. I haven't done much to protect myself on that, so...
Well,
I
let's
probably
talk
should've.
About how you can do that.
So please help me, Kim. Please walk me through what I should be doing. So maybe we can walk through like some different tips and tricks and what you suggest.
Sure. So, we're talking about tech here. So
yes, the tech
there are obvious things you can do outside of tech. Like, for example, do the delivery people for you just put the package right in the front, like, front center. I'm like, what are you doing?
Yep, just advertising it basically to everybody.
Yeah, like it may basically should just have a come steal me sign on it.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, so I mean, aside from the obvious, put a note out for the delivery person, please don't leave the package here, you know. We're talking about how tech can help. So, I mean, the biggest thing, the most obvious thing is to get yourself a security camera, right? There's so many outdoor security cameras and a lot of them aren't expensive at all. Like this little guy right here, I don't know if you can really see him here, but this is the TP-Link Costacam.
Okay.
It's $139, and it works well. It's got a magnetic base right here. This is one of
them. You can mount it somewhere.
You can mount it anywhere, high or low. This is just one of them. There's the Nest Cam. Ring has, this is the Ring home security system, but they have, as part of their larger ecosystem, they have several security cams, both, you know, battery operated and wired that can help you. And if you go to YouTube and type in like Ring security cam footage, you see so many people like being thwarted by by these security cameras because they either see it and run away or because you can actually talk to the would-be thieves through the cameras and video doorbells too, you can see them just like, oh, sorry, and they run away. And there's some kind of funny ones, like the woman who broke her ankle trying to steal packages.
Yeah, I feel really bad for you on that one.
Yeah, that's kind of hard to...
I mean, that's kind of the dream, isn't it, to like catch somebody? I mean, for me, maybe I shouldn't be saying that, but for me, it's like catching them in the act, and you can actually do it, yeah.
Yeah. Through an app on your phone, you can actually communicate with this person. So they camera service two, they have kind of two different or even three different purposes. The first one is to thwart the porch pirate in the first place. Like they're going to see the camera, they're going to go, oh no, I'm not even going there. Or
porch pirate's a good term too.
Yeah, porch pirate. That's or they will. You can talk to them and they'll put the package down and run. Or if for some reason you don't catch them, you have the footage. You can give the footage to the police. And how often have we seen it where the local news channels
Have you seen this man?
If you see this man, call police. Yeah.
Right.
So, so that's one way. There's also video doorbells.
Yeah, and this is actually something I was thinking about picking up, too. We're looking at some different footage here as we're talking about this of different people getting caught in the act thanks to this. So a video doorbell, what are some of the best ones, and I guess what do they do for you?
It's similar to the video camera, except for they are located, and they work as actual doorbells. So you can correspond via the video doorbell. You can see, what's going on. Mm-hmm. And the best ones are definitely Ring is the one of the best. They have, I think, four different video doorbells now. They have the Ring Original, two Pro, and the Elite. The Nest Hello is also a very good one, too. And there's all kinds of other ones coming on the market really soon.
I feel like Ring and Nest are the two names that I hear the most when it comes to it. And Ring, who did they, is it Amazon?
Yes.
Registering? Okay, yeah, I want to make sure I get
yes,
that
Yes, they're now
and then Google
owned
purchased
by...
Nest.
Yes.
So,
you know.
Yeah. So you're right back into the Google and Amazon wars.
Right.
Okay, so a doorbell, that's another great way to do it. What would you suggest if you had to pick one or the other, the outside camera or the doorbell?
Oh, that's a good question.
I actually don't
have a video doorbell installed right now. We just have cameras. Yeah. They both serve purposes. I mean, if you're looking for just one thing, the video doorbell might have a little bit more functionality to it.
Okay.
Because, you know, if somebody's ringing the doorbell, even if they don't ring the doorbell, there's the motion alert you can get and sort of still be, you know, kind of aware of what's going on. And the original Ring, a video doorbell, I think is like $99.
So yeah,
it's really affordable.
Yeah,
it's really affordable.
Do you have to pay a subscription service after that?
For Ring, yes. There is a small monthly monitoring fee. I think they start at like $3 or $4 a month. So
okay, that's not too
bit
bad
of a downside, yeah. But yeah. But you do, you know, Ring still makes you pay extra.
Okay. So you got the doorbell, you got the outside security camera. What are some other ways to protect your packages?
There's these fringe things. There's this thing called the porch pirate. Have you heard of it?
Yeah.
No, sorry, package guard, excuse me.
Package guard?
Yeah, it's this little flat thing. I should have brought it in. I'm sorry, guys, but
They can go to digitaltrends.com and look it up.
Yeah. It's this little pad that you put on your front porch. And it says place package here on it, and you place the package on it, and then if so, you know the delivery person doesn't, if somebody picks it up, an alarm goes off, and you get a notification to your phone. It's still in the crowdfunding stage.
Okay, they could still just run off though, couldn't they?
Yeah.
If you had a camera, I guess that would.
Again, though, yeah.
Yeah. All right. So.
It's enough, probably, of a deterrent for most people, I would
right.
think. But yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
That we'll let you know when we get the opportunity to test that one out.
What are some other ones that are on the market now that you can do? I know there's like the Amazon Key service if you want
yeah.
to just avoid.
The Amazon Key service is kind of a combination of Amazon, the Amazon Cloud Cam, and the ability to I think you have to have a specific lock. I think August. I can't. But in any mm-hmm. case.
Oh yeah, yeah.
There's a code. So this is what happens. The person who delivers it, you know, gets access to go inside your house to
yeah.
leave the packages inside. People who I've talked to have used it, love it.
I know Caleb here at Digital Trends, he uses it, right?
I don't know. There's a couple people here who have used
yeah.
it before. I wrote an op-ed saying I was creeped out by it, but... But now that, you know, I'm getting all these packages, I'm like, you know, it would
yeah.
be such a terrible thing to just have those packages sitting inside my house.
I mean, the more that we get stuff delivered, and especially just, I mean, everything's getting delivered right now. That kind of idea, I mean, it's weird letting somebody into your house, a stranger.
Right.
But at the same time, they're supposed to be verified, you know, in theory. And there's also a camera noting when they go in and they leave.
Right.
If you add in that camera.
They're recording the transaction.
Yeah.
So if the delivery person decides to go berserk and start stealing stuff, you have footage
yeah.
of that at least.
Yeah. So so you got the Amazon Key service, another one if you really want to go that full on board. And then any other suggestions that you would have for people trying to keep their packages like me from being stolen?
Well,
other than being there on the porch at all times.
Yeah, just, you yeah. know, you should just be looking out the window with binoculars.
Set up a lawn chair, yeah,
yeah.
and be watching it
and
all
yelling
times.
At the kids.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, I will say one other thing about Ring is, and several other, like Vivint, which is a whole home security system that you have to have installed.
Yeah, and that's what I've kind of debated on. I have a home security system now. So there you go, in case anybody was planning on heading over to my house. But but it doesn't protect my porch. So... I was debating on whether getting, you know, this kind of a system, like a Ring system where you kind of are in control of it yourself, or an actual security system.
Right. this security system kind of has both. You can get professional home monitoring, but
you can, yes.
Okay. But you do have to pay a little extra per month, but you do with the professional systems too,
yeah.
where they come in and install it for you. It's really, you know, just up to your personal preference.
Okay.
If you already have a few like home security items, you might want to get like something like Ring, where you can set it up as you like, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But there are companies like Vivint is probably the the most current and popular, like they come in and install everything for you, and you can pick from a whole selection of cameras, motion detectors. I don't believe they have a video doorbell, but they definitely, and they provide the home monitoring for you. And you know what home, does everybody know what home monitoring means?
That
means
maybe like, just to clarify that. Yeah.
Yeah, it means, you know, if something happens, they contact you, like say they're a motion detector set off while you're not home, while your system is armed. They contact you. If they can't reach you, they call the police.
Yep.
And so you get that extra protection from law enforcement.
That's what I have right now, too, actually. You know, yeah, so basically an alarm will go off, like somebody opens a door or something and it sets off the alarm. They'll try to call you. If they can't call you, they call the police. Police show up.
Yeah.
Which is really embarrassing if you accidentally set it off.
Yes.
And then you don't pay attention.
Yes, definitely.
Because I've driven off and not paid attention to my phone, and then I get a call from the police, like, we're at your house, and there's nothing going on here. I'm like, yep, because I didn't pay attention. So, yeah, but regardless, it's nice to know that that opportunity is there if you do need it.
Yes.
So that's like the full-on home monitoring system.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I will say with Ring, you know, they also come with a neighbor. There's an app that you can actually share footage. So say somebody, you see some, you know, creeper lurking on your front porch, mm-hmm. doesn't take anything, but you can take that footage, and if you're connected with other, you know,
yeah.
people on the app, you can show them that footage, you can send and receive.
Like, hey, this dude's in the neighborhood.
Yeah, this dude was creeping around my porch.
Yeah.
Last night, and so there are apps out there that can help you as well.
Cool. Well, this gives some good ideas on how to prevent the package thieving.
Yes, but none of this stuff prevents the UPS guy from not ringing the doorbell. Have you ever had that happen
yeah.
when you're not home and
no,
they just
yeah.
leave a package and it sits there for an hour and you don't
Every
even
time.
Know it's
there? I don't think I've ever had somebody ring the
so
doorbell.
So annoying.
But yeah, I mean, and that's just kind of, I think, what we just have to get used to.
Yeah.
You know, because that's how it is.
They're in a hurry. I guess they can't push a button.
Well, you can check out everything that Kim's talking about at digitaltrends.com under the smart home section there. There's so many good articles under your category at Digital Trends. It's always fun to read about it and just see where things are going. Any other suggestions for people to follow? How can they follow you? What's the best Twitter handle for you?
KimDog.
KimDog.
D-O-G-G. D-O-double-G.
D-O-double-G.
Because I'm gangster or something.
Yeah. No. So there you heard it. You heard it here first. Gangster Kim. You can Kim Dog, follow her on Twitter. Check out all of the articles on our smart home section. And Kim, thanks so much for hopping in here too. This
sure
was awesome.
Thing.